Two former Connecticut politicians, one of whom was recently incarcerated, are looking to get back in the mix here with Chris Keating, Capitol Bureau Chief, HarperCollins, a regular contributor here. Fascinating story. Ernie Newton, named for the past 17 years as a lawmaker, state senator, goes to jail for 4 years for corruption, gets out in 2010. Said he wants his job back. He's finished up all his probationary stuff, so he's a free man. Says he's changed, he's repented, he's made a mistake. He sees a void in leadership. He wants to come back. Let's take a look at Ernie's comments in his own words.
Okay.
Every time somebody comes to you and says, well, Ernie can't be trusted, he's a felon, just remind them that every saint has a past, and every sinner has a future.
Ernie was preaching. Every saint has a past, every sinner has a future. Interesting strategy. You've known Ernie Newton for a long time, known as well as anyone. Your personal thoughts on him and this sort of effort to get back into the mix?
It's absolutely amazing. I mean, I was there when Ernie was sentenced. The judge basically threw the book at him, sentenced
him. And so basically he sold his office. Not only sentenced him, but chastised him and said, you know what, you sold your office. When people came to help you, they had to buy you first. That's what he basically said.
The judge totally lowered the boom on him. A little bit before that, I was there at the speech in the pouring rain when Ernie said he was the Moses of his people.
I remember that.
So he came out and said he was the Moses of his people. At the sentencing, the judge came back out and said that he never saw any references in the Bible where Moses came in and was charging everyone to talk to him, which is what happened with Ernie. So the judge absolutely lowered the boom on Ernie, huge.
The judge had a Bible too. He's reading his Bible, the judge.
Well, he said there were no references in the Bible to anything that Ernie was talking about.
Could have a spiritual judge on the bench, I guess.
Yeah, but anyway, Ernie is a three-time convicted felon, okay? He pleaded guilty to three felonies, and a lot of people thought Ernie would not come back. However, a long time ago, way back, he was even talking, even before he was sentenced, about a comeback. You know, I think a lot of people didn't believe him, thought it might have been a bit much, but Ernie actually mentioned that way back then, was talking about a comeback, and it's a remarkable story.
Well, here's a guy who's an exceedingly charming guy, right? Dapper. He overcame a cocaine addiction years ago. People like him. He's a very likable guy, right? Street savvy. And as he'll tell you, in his community, with his constituents, serving time is not necessarily the red letter it is in other communities. And he's kind of banking on being the people of the streets and folks seeing his jail time not as this bad thing per se. So with all that in Bridgeport, can a guy like him come back and actually win?
It's a possibility. I mean, in Bridgeport, he's known, he's been there forever.
Right.
You can't take that away from people. Sometimes talk about Ganem trying to run again, et cetera. Ernie could not win statewide, obviously. In his own hometown, there is a chance. One thing you have to remember is they had an incredibly strong case against Ernie. It was one of the longest running wiretaps in recent Connecticut history.
Right.
It kept getting renewed by the judges. They had Ernie on like 7,000 conversations.
Right, wiretaps.
And almost 400 of those were deemed incriminating. They really had Ernie on the wiretaps. They had him dead to rights, and he basically pleaded guilty, obviously.
Right.
If it had gone to trial, there was a lot of evidence against Ernie.
But you know as well as I do, there are people in Bridgeport, when it comes to Joe Ganem, who will tell you to your face, they'll vote for it. They would vote for him again right now if he ran. So what does that tell you? There are people who are willing to look past the indiscretions, the corruption. So that's why I find it really intriguing with these characters, the Marion Barrys, the Buddy Cianci's in Rhode Island, that go to jail, they come back. There's still a base for them. That's fascinating.
Yes, there's only a certain kind of politician who could pull that off. I don't know whether Ernie's going to win or not, but certainly he's in the game. He's got support. He had his mother there and a lot of his supporters there.
We're trying to get him on here. What do you think? We're trying on the show.
Bring
here.
Bring him on. He wouldn't talk to me at the end, you know, but previous to that, as you said, he was very gregarious, very outgoing guy, very well-known guy at the Capitol, et cetera, et cetera. But again, they had a very strong case against him, and he was convicted.
All right, Chris Shays, the other guy coming out. He wasn't in jail, but he's been on ICE for a little bit. Now he wants to come back, former congressman, looking at the U.S. Senate seat. Your thoughts on his reemergence?
Yeah, well, Shays is coming back basically after 2 years. He lost in 08 in basically a Democratic landslide of sorts. He was the last Republican House member in New England.
And maybe Shays, the last moderate Republican ever, right? He's the one who has actually embraced being a moderate Republican, not trying to be too right or too whatever. He's embraced being a moderate Republican.
Yeah,
right?
he was one of the last of the moderates. Rob Simmons lost before him. Nancy Johnson lost before him. Shays was, it's almost a contradiction in terms, but a hardcore moderate, if you can be that.
Yeah.
He's running against Linda McMahon. Shays is a newsmaker. He will do things and say things that will get him in the news. I can't predict what those might be, but Shays will not go down without a fight. He keeps saying his total focus is on the primary August 14th, which to many insiders think that he won't win the convention against Linda McMahon.
Right.
Others are not ruling him out in the convention, don't get me wrong, but a lot of people think that he's in it till the primary.
After McMahon, who else should he worry about? Anyone else there in the mix? Who will be the top three people looking to as competitors
On the Republican side, they're the two biggest players, McMahon and Shays.
And Democratic
are the two
side?
Biggest. Democratic side, there's Chris Murphy, Bisewitz, Representative Tong from Stanford. So there's a series of candidates in this race. It's a good race, a solid race, and it'll be entertaining for people who follow it.
All right, well, other question. Now, let's segue to the math. Math and the governor's office now, there's some issues here. I wonder if their math skills, like my math skills, which are not very good, the pension fund. They're saying the governor estimated over 20 years there'd be X amount of $1 billion of savings.
Correct.
The independent group that studies this says no, they're off by $3 billion on their estimates over 20 years. Big problem. How do you explain a $3 million discrepancy in 15 seconds?
Well, there's a big fight going on that. Governor Malloy says one side is wrong, the other side says Malloy is wrong. $3 billion is a big, big gap when you're only talking on a base about $4 or $5 billion.
Right.
We're not fighting over $300 billion
That's
and we're off
money.
By three. Real money, no question about it.
10 seconds. The state deficit, now it's projected at $144 million. A month ago, they were calling a surplus. In 5 seconds, what's up with that?
The money did not come in as good as expected. The Wall Street bonuses were lower. A lot of the big hitters in Greenwich weren't paying as much money.
Yeah.
When you add all that up, you don't have as much money.
Did your bonus come in this year?
I wanted it to.
All right.
You get one for me?
You're one of those big Wall Street guys.
Sign
out
me
there.
Up.
My bonus didn't come in either.
Sign
right.
me up.
We come back. Chris Keating, Harper Kern, Capital Bureau
Chief. I get on a debit card.
Get this bonus coming in. Get the bonus coming in, Keating. Coming up next to Bucky
Fine,
Jones,
man.
Andrew Penix, Scott Gray. We're going to talk about the Super Bowl and get their predictions and have a special surprise to you. Don't go away. Catch us 24/7, ctnow.com/Stan. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter.